Good morning, children. Welcome back to the channel Awesome Learning. And we have started with the chapter Respiration in Plants. So the second topic that we are going to do in this chapter is glycolysis or EMP pathway. So let's begin. Glyco is glucose or glycogen, and lysis means breaking down. So let's see what is it all about. So glycolysis or EMP pathway, children, it is the partial oxidation or breakdown of glucose to two molecules of pyruvic acid in the absence of oxygen. So children, you know what is partial oxidation or partial combustion and what is combustion. Combustion is a process in which full breakdown takes place. That is, the compound is broken down into very simplest form. That is complete combustion. But partial combustion or partial oxidation is when there is incomplete breakdown. Okay, so glucose is a molecule which is C6. We all know that glucose has 6 carbons. Okay, so in this glycolysis, it is the partial oxidation, that is partial breakdown of glucose from C6 to 2 molecules. Pyruvate is C2. From C6 to 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. Okay, from C6 to 2 molecules of pyruvic acid. So it is not completely breaking down, because we all know that when glucose will break down, what should we get? We should get carbon dioxide. That is the simplest form. And if that takes place, it is complete oxidation. But here it is not, it is the only the first step. And what is the first step? Glucose, which is C6, is broken down into pyruvate. 2 molecules of pyruvate or pyruvic acid in the absence of oxygen. That is, anaerobically the breakdown is taking place. Where does it take place? It takes place in the cytoplasm of the living organism. So very easy, quite easy. You have understood that glucose, that is C6 carbon glucose, gets broken down into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid in the absence of oxygen. And this, all this process takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell. Okay. Now let's see here, in its scheme was given by Gustav Emden, Otto Meyerhoff and J. Parnas. So that is why it is known as EMP pathway. E, M for Meyerhoff and P for Parnas. So we also call it as EMP pathway, just because they were this pathway was discovered by these scientists. So in anaerobes, it is the only process of respiration. So only the process of respiration in anaerobes is the EMP pathway or glycolysis. This is the only one option they have. Those organisms which respire anaerobically, this is the only pathway they follow, right? Then children, here, in plants, glucose is derived from sucrose. Okay, sucrose is the end product of photosynthesis, or from the storage of carbohydrates. So where do we get glucose? This is what is made during photosynthesis. The product we get after the photosynthesis is complete, the product we get is sucrose. Now this sucrose is converted into glucose and fructose by the presence of enzyme invertase. So whatever is the product of photosynthesis, what is the product of photosynthesis? It is sucrose. But it is not stored in plants in the form of sucrose. So plants will store this sucrose by converting this into glucose and fructose by the help of enzyme invertase. सो प्रोडक्शन तो सुक्रोज की हो रही है, बट सुक्रोज के फॉर्म में स्टोर नहीं करेंगे, उसको क्या करेंगे, सुक्रोज को पहले कन्वर्ट करेंगे एंड फिर स्टोर करेंगे. सो सुक्रोज इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूकोज एंड फ्रक्टोज बाय द एंजाइम इनवर्टेज. सो दीज टू मोनोसैकराइड्स, बोथ ऑफ देम आर मोनोसैकराइड्स, ओके, रेडिली एंटर इनटू ग्लाइकोलिटिक पाथवे. सो बोथ ऑफ देम इजिली एंटर द ग्लाइकोलिटिक पाथवे, दैट इज दिस पाथवे. Okay, so we have got the glucose. Now we will, yahan par just above, you can write it in continuation that sucrose, the sucrose gets converted into glucose and then this glucose can enter into the glycolytic pathway or the EMP pathway. So first sucrose is produced, but it is being converted into glucose, right? And glucose easily, readily enters into the EMP pathway. Sucrose will not enter into the EMP pathway. Okay. Now, glucose and fructose are phosphorylated to form glucose 6-phosphate. Now, in my first, you can say raw material. This is my first raw material. Either I am having glucose or I am having fructose or I am having both. So, whatever is the raw material, whether it is glucose or it is fructose or maybe we have both, that is being broken down into first compound, first product, that is glucose 6-phosphate. Now, here phosphate has been added, so that is why the step is called phosphorylation. Okay, so glucose and fructose are phosphorylated and they are get converted into glucose 6-phosphate with the presence of enzyme hexokinase. This is the enzyme hexokinase which will help in the phosphorylation of glucose and fructose into glucose 6-phosphate. Okay, then subsequent step, then next steps will follow. Subsequent steps of metabolism of glucose and fructose are same. That is, whether it is glucose, all the steps will be same. If it is fructose, all the steps will be same. If it is glucose, the first product you will get is glucose 6-phosphate. But if it is fructose, the first product you will get is fructose 6-phosphate. And then after this, all the steps are same, whether you get you are proceeding with glucose 6-phosphate or you are proceeding with fructose 6-phosphate. Okay, again I am repeating, if you are having glucose, then glucose will get converted into glucose 6-phosphate with the help of enzyme hexokinase. But if you are having fructose, then the fructose will get converted into fructose 6-phosphate again with the help of enzyme hexokinase. Whatever is your raw material, according to that you will get the first product. After this, after the first product, all the subsequent steps or all the steps further are same, whether you follow this or you follow fructose 6-phosphate. So let's see glycolysis or EMP pathway and the various steps of glycolysis. Now we will start with glucose. It is a 6-carbon compound as you see here. So the first step is changing of glucose or phosphorylation rather we should say of glucose into glucose 6-phosphate. And you also know which enzyme is responsible for this. We have done it here. Hexokinase is the enzyme. So you can write here. They have not written, but you should write down the enzymes along the arrow so that one chart will have all the information that is being used for in the step of glycolysis. Now, this first step, children, as you see, six carbon of glucose is getting converted into 6-carbon of glucose 6-phosphate. तो अभी कार अभी कोई का ब्रेकडाउन नहीं हुआ. My first raw material was 6-carbon and the first step or the product I am getting in the first step is again 6-carbon. That is, no breakdown has taken place. Only what has been done, phosphate has been added. So that means phosphorylation has been done, right? And here one ATP is used, you see, because ATP gets converted into ADP. So one ATP is used here, right? Then this the second step you see second step is glucose 6 phosphate gets converted into fructose 6 phosphate again a 6 carbon compound right and the third step is fructose 6 phosphate will converted into fructose 1,6 biphosphate now why biphosphate because at first carbon also phosphate is added and sixth carbon also phosphate is added so two are there so biphosphate but the amount of carbon are same that is breaking down has not yet occurred here also one ATP is being spent So all these steps are phosphorylation steps because phosphate has been added up, right? Here phosphate was added on the sixth position, here also on sixth position, but here it was added on first and sixth position, right? So let's read what they have written is, it includes 10 steps under the control of different enzymes. ATP is utilized at two steps. You can see here also ATP was utilized, here also ATP was utilized. In the conversion of glucose into glucose 6 phosphate, first ATP was utilized here, and in the conversion of fructose 6 phosphate to fructose 1,6 diphosphate or biphosphate, whatever you write, the second ATP was used here. So two ATPs have already been spent in three steps. I hope this is very much clear to all of you. Now, children, next. Further, let's move on. Our last product here was fructose 1,6 biphosphate. Let's continue with the same. See, fructose 1,6 biphosphate, again a 6 carbon compound, further moves on to the steps. We get PGAL, which is 3 carbon, and DHAP, which is again 3 carbon. That means here first breaking down has taken place. 6 carbon compound has been splitted into 3 carbon compounds. You see? 3 plus 3, 6, right? So let's see, read here, fructose 1,6 diphosphate is split into dihydroxyacetone phosphate, that is DHAP, and 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde, that is PGAL. So both of them are 3 carbon compounds, that is first breaking down has taken place in step number 4. Okay, now let's move on with 3-PGAL, that is phosphoglyceraldehyde. This is oxidized, that means we will add up oxygen here with inorganic phosphate gets converted into 1,3-biphosphoglycerate. So PGAL gets converted or gets oxidized with inorganic phosphate. That means oxygen is also used, phosphate is also used, and this gets converted into biphosphoglycerate. Biphosphoglycerate. And how many molecules of biphosphoglycerate? 2 molecules of biphosphoglycerate. But here again it is 3 carbon compound. That is, yahan par koi breakdown nahi hua. It is just getting converted into a next form, into a simplest form. But again PGAL is 3 carbon, BPGA is also 3 carbon. And here NADP plus is getting converted into or getting reduced because addition of hydrogen has taken place into NADH plus H plus. Right? So you can see during this 2 redox equivalence, 2 hydrogen atoms are removed, of course, and from PGAL because I am saying oxidation. So how will the oxidation take place? Either oxygen is added or hydrogen is removed. So how many hydrogen is removed? 2 hydrogen atoms are removed from PGAL. Okay, and that is given, these 2 hydrogen are given to NADP plus. So one hydrogen is added up here and the second one is added up here. So 2 hydrogen from PGAL were taken out, and because hydrogen were taken out, so this got oxidized. And these 2 hydrogens were used by NADP to get reduced into NADH plus H plus. Okay, so this transformation has taken place. Now next step, you see BPGA becomes 3-phosphoglyceric acid. See, BPGA becomes 3, again carbon are same, 3 carbon. But how many? Because two molecules of BPGA, so two molecules of phosphoglyceric acid are formed here. And here in this step, ATP is not used, it is generated. So here the ATP is generated. This is this energy is trapped by the formation of ATP. Okay, so two molecules of BPGA get converted into two molecules of phosphoglyceric acid, and in this step one ATP is being generated. I hope this is clear. Now let's move on to the next step. We have got two molecules of PGA, which are PGA is a three carbon compound. Now here this again is broken down into four, that is phosphoglycerate, again three carbon compound. See, ATP is also removed when phosphoenol pyruvate, that is PEP, converts to pyruvic acid. See, PGA gets converted into phosphoglycerate, and this phosphoglycerate by taking out of water molecule gets converted into PEP, that is phosphoenol pyruvate. And phosphoenol pyruvate, when gets converted into pyruvic acid, two molecules of pyruvic acid, but three carbon compound. Okay, so again one ATP is being generated. So all in all, in glycolysis, four ATP molecules are directly synthesized. You know, because two. There are two molecules ना, तो अगर एक PEP breakdown हो रहा है तो एक ATP, तो अगर दो PEP breakdown हो रहे हैं तो how many ATP? Two. Similarly here, अगर एक BPGA convert हो रहा है PG में तो एक ATP generate हो रहा है, तो दो अगर convert हो रहे हैं तो how many? तो दो ATP यहाँ and दो ATP यहाँ generate हो रहे हैं, तो total all in all four ATP molecules are synthesized from one glucose molecule. Now here pyruvic acid or pyruvate, you can say, is the key product of glycolysis. Its metabolic fate depend on the cellular need. Now it depends upon the need of the cell. So aage jaake ye pyruvate kitna breakdown hota hai aur kaise breakdown hota hai, that depends upon the requirement of the cell. Okay, so children, you can see this is all the steps of glycolysis have been summed up here in one chart. You can note down this chart and you can see everything is being, even I would suggest to all of you that you can even write the enzymes being used in between the steps, so that you have everything in one chart only. Okay, so we will continue with the glycolysis in the next video also. I don't want this video to be too long.